Hey guys, today on JD Cars, we're painting a whole new bumper using only rattle cans. And here's why. The car is 10 years old, and after having many miles put on it, it has a ton of rock chips on the front bumper, as you can see here. I've also got the holes still remaining from the old license plate holder, which aren't very attractive, nor are the rock chips covering the entire front bumper. So we've got a brand new bumper here, and I'm not using just any old spray paint. I got this paint custom mixed from Paint Scratch. As you can see, it's color matched specifically for my model, 2007 BMW Jet Black, paint code 668. So this should match up perfectly with my factory paint. I'm also using Paint Scratch adhesion promoter, primer, base coat of course, and I'm using Spray Max 2K clear coat. I do have a compressor and a spray gun, but I was really curious to see what the difference is when painting an auto body part with spray cans compared to a spray gun. So let's go ahead and get this new bumper unwrapped. So here's the new bumper. Looks pretty nice. I honestly can't tell any difference between this and the factory bumper. This is advertised as pre-primered, but I'm just gonna stay consistent and go ahead and prime it with the Paint Scratch primer to ensure I have good adhesion when I apply the base coat. First things first, I'm gonna grab a Scotch-Brite pad and we're gonna go ahead and scuff it up. By the way, I'll have a link to all the products used in this video in the description below. Alright, I've just spent probably a solid 15-20 minutes sanding this down. Went through a couple of the Scotch-Brite pads, good to switch them out. It's important to get into all the cracks and crevices of the bumper and even the undersurfaces, such as right here, because if you don't adequately sand it, it can peel and the entire paint job could be ruined. I'm gonna be using Rapid Prep to clean all of that sanding dust off the surface. So first thing we're gonna be doing is applying the adhesion promoter. We've got nice simple directions here on the back. I have to shake the can for a minute. Then we'll apply one light coat, which is gonna be a mist coat. We'll wait 5 minutes for it to flash. Then we'll apply a wet coat, wait 15 minutes for it to flash, and then we'll do a final coat. So, obviously tack off the surface. Now we're good to go ahead and apply the adhesion promoter. Now we wait 5 minutes before applying our next coat. All right, it's been 5 minutes. Remember to shake this again before reapplying. When you're done with the adhesion promoter, you can go ahead and invert it and press the tip and clear the excess fluid. 5 to 10 minutes later here, we can go ahead and apply the primer. We're gonna shake the can for a minute, then we're going to apply 2 to 3 medium wet coats from 6 to 8 inches, and 1 hour later, it can be sanded in preparation for the base coat. So we've applied our first coat here. I'm gonna apply 1 or 2 more coats, waiting 5 to 10 minutes in between each coat. All right, here's what it looks like with 3 coats of primer. As you can see, I tried very hard to make this as uniform as possible, and it came out pretty flawless. We now have to wait 1 hour before we can scuff this up and apply the base coat. All right, it's been about 1 hour now, and bumper's now dry to the touch, and we can scuff it up for paint. Now when sanding this primer that's still fairly new, you need to be very, very gentle and apply minimal pressure. All right, I just spent probably close to 30 minutes sanding this down. It's really important to get even the smallest little bumps out of it because it'll affect the final finish. Now I'm gonna wipe it down with some Rapid Prep and a clean microfiber. Now it's time to shake this up and apply it to the bumper. We will apply 2 to 3 light coats at a distance of 10 to 12 inches. Flash time is 5 to 10 minutes and the dry time is 1 hour. I'd like to love you, love you. So after the first coat, there isn't much of a noticeable difference. It was really just a light misting. Following this will be a bit heavier coats. Here it is after the second coat, starting to develop a bit more color. I did just run out of paint at the end of the second coat here, so I am a little concerned as I only have one more can. It's been about 10 minutes, I'm gonna move on to coat number 3. Here it is after the third coat, really starting to develop some color now. My final paint can is getting pretty low, so I'm really not sure if I'll have enough. All right, the third coat has flashed and it's time for the fourth coat. Here it is after the fourth coat. Good news is it's coming along nicely and the color's really developing. Here's the bad news. Both my base coat cans are empty and I'm gonna have to order more. Now, since they mix this color up custom and they have hundreds of customers, I'm not really sure how long this is gonna take. All right, the next clip will probably be 2 weeks from now. See you then. Okay, folks, we are back. Since last time when we ran out of paint, I've installed both the NAVD and the new steering wheel cover on the car. We're filming on the new camera. And fresh in from paint scratch, we've got two more cans of paint. It's been a while since we last painted this, so I'm gonna go ahead and scuff it up with Scotch-Brite pad. Just wiped this whole thing down, tacked it off, and we're ready to spray. We'll be using the same guidelines as before on the back of the can. All right, it took about 5 coats to get good enough coverage because we used a white primer. We're now moving on to the clear coat. As you can see, I'm using a 2K clear coat, which is more resistant to damage such as scratches. To activate this two-part clear coat, we're gonna remove the red cap from the top. Then we take it, push it onto the bottom here. Then push it against the ground firmly. Now thoroughly shake it up for 2 minutes. Now we're gonna spray from approximately 10 inches away, and we're gonna wait 10 to 15 minutes in between coats. Definitely wear a respirator throughout this entire process. Doesn't look that great on camera, but in person this looks really good after just the first coat of clear coat. So I got 4 coats out of those 2 cans of clear coat. Now I have to wait at least 12 hours for this to dry. I'll probably give it at least a week before I polish it up because I don't want to burn through the new clear coat. 24 hours later here and the paint job is looking really good. As you can see, it does still have some minor orange peel to it, so I'm gonna go ahead and wet sand it and then compound and polish it. Since I've already made a video about this, I'm not gonna show it in this video, but if you wanna see how to wet sand, compound, and polish, check out my other video right here. Alrighty guys, it's all done, and as you can see, the paint job came out absolutely beautifully. Purposely catch the camera and myself in the frame here, and you can see this thing has a mirror-like reflection. That is a reflection, just to show you how reflective this is, and as you can see, the color match is absolutely flawless. I couldn't be happier with how this came out. I'd like to pay a great thanks to George Sears, the founder of Redline Automotive Detailing, for helping me out and polishing this bumper to perfection. I'd also like to take a moment to appreciate the fact that this finish came out of a spray can, which is truly hard to believe given the quality of it. This goes to show that you can do a great job even with very limited resources. Anyways guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like below and subscribe if you've yet to do so. I also just launched a JD Cars Instagram, so you guys can follow me there at JD.cars if you'd like to see some behind the scenes shots. Thanks guys, I'll see you next time on JD Cars.